playing from errands as 20 FB.
Okay, Graham. Yeah, can you show us the post-it, please?
Post-it for you. Left tail, Codlunga. Boar's tooth, Dente de Chingado. Middle iron gate, Metsupport to the Fellow. Middle iron gate, Metsupport to the Fellow. Full iron gate, through the port to the Fellow. Right tail, Codlunga. Woman, or window, fenestra, bicorno or anvil or unicorn, lunga or long, would be a foot. We have fenestra on the left, didana on the left, crown or frontale or front, breve or short, breve.
Okay, so let's see you do the post-it drill where you just flow from one to the next. If you don't need to name them, just do it. Can you describe that weapon to us?
Sure, so this is a longsword. The blade, it begins with the tip, with the weak of the sword, the mid, the strong, goes through the tang, which goes to the handle, ending with the pommel, or the pin at the end, in this case. We also have the crossguard, the true edge of the blade, which is the side where your knuckles are, the false edge, which is the opposite side. So in this case, this is the true edge, this is the false edge. This is not the true edge, this is not the false edge. Very exciting. We have the points of percussion. One is in the handle, and one is around here. This is the most effective energy transference point on the sword, because when you strike it, it's not wobbling back and forth. We have the point of balance, which is about 2 to 3 centimeters out from the crossguard. And that is the point around which you want to turn the sword when you're straight.
Okay. Can you demonstrate the attacks that Fiore describes?
So there is a fendente on the right. So it's a 15-degree cut going from teeth to knees on your opponent, striking through. And all of the motions in Fiore, for the most part, can be taken from one poster to another. So you take it from Udana, cutting the pendente through into horses. And from the right, we have a true regiment sun from the right, which is horizontal cut around the neck. We have a false edge satani from the right. So going from knees to teeth, a relatively shallow angle cut. So again, cutting. And you end up in Udana on the left. And from Udana on the left, you can throw a left finite. And then a left false edge with Sunny. And a left false edge Sakashi. And then you can thrust, which goes down the middle. And you can throw into either side. A number of posts there. If you wish.
What's that?
What part of the sword do you hit with?
Every part of the sword.
Follow up question. What part of the sword do you cut with?
The blade portion. The part that strikes the opponent, unless one of these other sections is sharpened.
Is there, with the mechanics of the sword, is there an ideal portion of the sword that you would cut with ideally?
Ideally, from the mid to near the tip. So not necessarily right in the note of percussion because it's relatively short, but not right at the tip because there's not very much mass, but somewhere in the sweet spot is the most momentum and force transfer.
Okay.
Oh, does anyone have a question? Mm-hmm. What? Do all the cuts have to flow through a particular post?
They do not have to flow through a particular post. Oh, sorry, yes, longer. I was thinking beginning. Yes, you're right. All the cuts can flow. If you stop them on point of impact, it's through longer. Which is following up George Silver would say, putting your threat very far from you, keeping your target very far back. Thrust is
okay, blade engagements. So, Mike, so what are the blade engagements, and can you demonstrate, please?
So there are four blade engagements, three of which involve actually touching the blade. So there's the deflection, which is around a 15 degree angle cut into your opponent's flat with your edge, which is most easily demonstrated in the first play of longsword. You can strike in to the end of it, please. Deflect his weapon out of the way so it doesn't hit me, and I can strike him in a single time defense and offense. So deflection is the best way to do you can get it. Further, there is a beat, which is your edge against your opponent's flat. Let's you attack me with a Metsami, please. You can beat it down out of the way. There's no longer a threat, but now both of our points are offline, and I need it at least one other time to strike my opponent. So it's a two-time. And it provides him a lot of force, which gives him an idea that I'm about to strike him, so he can defend himself. Finally, there's a bind, where it's edge on edge, and all momentum comes to a halt. So if you can attack me with Fidente, please, and we'll go to the collar. And then, yeah, movement is stopping and perform other plays from there. It seems a great deal of Fiore's plays are from. And finally, there's a void where you don't engage the blade at all. This gives your opponent no information and allows you to do a single time defense if you can, and you don't get stuck. So if you can strike at my leg, please, I can strike your head. Single time defense, but dangerous.
Okay. Let's see some plays. Yeah. Okay, so. Let's see some Largo plays. Okay?
Okay.
So what is Mike, what do you want for Mike for Largo plays?
So if you can step in with a right foot strike, I'll defend my left foot with a passing step. With a passing step, please. And I'll defend my left foot. So we'll do the first play where you let me hit the center and just strike you in the head.
Yeah, maybe put on that so you can make the distance. I like that far distance. So you can actually strike.
And if you don't miss, or if you don't hit the strike, you can follow it up with a thrust. Alright, can you throw me that Finite again, please? If you can throw that Finite again, but take the center with a bit of force. The second play, moving around the blade. You can strike again, but keep your blade just sort of in front hallway, but in the center. Third play. And if we can strike at a slightly farther distance. Thank you. Second with an Asami, please. Alternatively, you strike again. So kick his knee, but not his knee. You can strike at my knee again, please. And you can strike where the bind ends a little bit higher. Kick you in the nuts, and then you bend over because you got hit in the nuts.
Copy Glotto.
Copy Glotto, okay. If you can throw me a very heavy attack as a peasant would. Again, please. Throw me a thrust, please. Change the thrust, thrust again. Break the thrust. And when we do that, if you can raise into finestra to defend yourself from being struck. Sword where the agent or the scholar takes the initiative. I think I'll step back a little bit, I'll whack him in the face. I'm going to fake a large Ansano at you. You defend with some help. Cover the line. Yeah. One more time, please. And if you do that action to me,
before we do straddle, can you show us how to defend if you have the sword just in one hand?
Sure. You can attack me with a fendente from the right, please. Mitsami from the right. It's Connie from the right. Fendente from the left. Sami from the left. Sami from the left.
Can you do those again without backing up?
Sure. Yeah. Sami. And we're going to get this. And I think now. Might as well show Griffin and Fendente. And a thrust, please.
Okay, can we do a thrust with them backing up? Okay. Straddle. So, what's going to be the difference with what Mike does?
So the difference
what you do
for this is that in straddle we're both right foot forward. So if you step in with your right foot, right foot forward, and we are closer than we are at largo, so more near the strong at the mid of the blade, as opposed to largo, or the more in the weak of the mid. And from here, either player can view the blades. So it's the fastest person to perform that play. But in this case, I'll be good. Can you please attack me and with this first set, allow me to take the center? You can go on again, please.
So Graham, just like with the dagger section, once you've crossed a strut up here, what, if anything, is telling you which play to do, both plays in the mouth?
So it's helpful, there's a number of plays you can do when we're crossed. If I have the center, so I have access to his head, I'm covered from his sword, I can use my left hand to grab various objects. If he is the center, I have to put my hand forward to strike me in the head with a hand. Inopportune, so I can use a place where I raise my sword and do this.
Okay, so set Mike up already to make the to do the
show us one more.
Okay, well, let's keep doing what we're doing. So I'm just taking the center for these.
Did that cover?
Yeah, one more right here. Center. Until I get tired. Now, if you can take the center, please. All right, push. Almost there. Take the center again. Almost there. Your throat cut or throat. Center again. Where we need a bit higher up. And one more where your pommel is available for you to grab. One more again, please. A little bit higher.
Can you please do that slower? And
just sure. Do it. Cover it. One more play. You can center again. Let's do that one more time.
Okay.
So, not this one.
Okay. So you get some more sugar. Everybody can gear up. Everybody gear up. We'll proceed with the next play test.
Yeah, so everybody who's fencing, please assemble here once you've put on all of your gear and we'll sort ourselves down to the appropriate order, okay? Please do it promptly. I'm not hung one goblin anymore.
There'll be a country reader on the video. I was
thinking. Where is that guy? What happened?
He was holding on.
Fresh. Fresh off.
of the lecture.
All right.
So,
I'm getting used to it. It's getting easier and easier to do. Just tending, you know, crafting this construction.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Sure.
Okay, so those of you who are sitting on the side, please be aware of our space. So when you are fencing, please be very aware of where you are at. Okay.
Can we get a marshal to maybe get somebody with a spear?
Yeah, I think it would be good actually if those of you who are going to be fencing,
I'll get a spear.
Maybe spread around.
Let's human shield.
Aaron and I will stay over on this side. And if you hear me yell hold, or anyone yell hold, please stop immediately, because we are very in close quarters here with lots of people watching. Okay.
Yeah.
You good? You ready? Okay.
There we go.
It's a direction.
Step forward. Ready? Okay, begin.
Hit.
Sir.
Okay. Begin.
in there.
Good. Two more passes. Good. Okay, so.
Drink?
Sure. Yeah, take a quick drink. That concludes the formal evaluated portion of the test. Graham is now going to fence the three scholars and provosts to their pleasure.
That's always stuck.
So that was about 30 seconds.
Don't take too much pleasure.
Why do you guys need a saddle? It's a little awesome.
The more
easy
they become.
I just get a grin behind the mask there. And I'm like, yeah. Let's do this.
All right, Graham.
So just study.
All right.
go. Scholars outside, please.
Yeah, I think I'll put a nice little one for
my It's a good spot.
So after consulting with the scholars, it is my absolute pleasure to present you with the rank of scholar. So when you are awarded the prize of scholar. That means that all the other scholars who have attended are all good with welcoming you into the peerage.
Rohan, do you want to say something?
Thank you. So in a moment we're going to invite Graham to join us in the Circle of Scholars for our closing. Thank you everyone who came to bear witness to Graham's wonderful test. It is incumbent on every scholar and on you, Graham, to seek out every scholar here and solicit feedback. That feedback, of course, will proceed infinitely, of course, but feedback specifically with respect to your test, and that's the things to take back to the cell and begin to work on. Congratulations, and please join the circle. Thank you, all of us.
Like you fucked already, and now you're like, I'm not even.